everyone. So the next topic which we will be studying is about the dimorphism. So in this particular slides we will be discussing about the sexual dimorphism. So what is sexual dimorphism? Sexual dimorphism is a disorder in which the sexes with the same species have distinct traits that go beyond the sexual organ variations. So most of the plants and the animals suffer from this disease because there are secondary sex characteristics, that is height, weight, color, markings and behavioral and cognitive variations, which makes all the difference. So sexual dimorphism meaning tells that these distinctions can be subtle or extreme and they can be influenced by sexual or the natural selection. Monomorphism is the exact opposite of the dimorphism. So the word dimorphism meaning in sexual dimorphism stands for occurring in two distinct forms or describing two distinct forms. Now, sexual dimorphism in humans. So in case of humans, there are five factors that are responsible for determining the sex in humans. That is the presence or absence of Y chromosome, the internal reproductive anatomy, that is including the uterus in females, the sex organs, the forms of gonads, and the external genitalia. So these are the sexual dimorphism in humans. So these five variables are usually either all the humans or all the males. Sexual dimorphism in humans rarely experience sexual ambiguity, but when it does, the individual is biologically identified as intersex. The gonads, breast, external genitals, internal genitals, body mass and the endocrine system, height and their physiological and behavioral effects are all examples of sexual dimorphism in humans. The existence or absence of a Y chromosome that encodes the biochemical modifiers for sexual development in males influences human sexual differentiation, specifically at the gene level. So in adolescents, the male basal metabolic rate has been approximately 6% higher than those in females, and it rises to almost 10% greater following the puberty. So males turn more food to muscle and expandable circulating energy stores, whereas females transfer more into fat. So according to aggregated data on absolute strength, females have 40 to 60% of males upper body strength and 70 to 75% of males lower body strength. If I talk about the teenagers, so in teen years, females are taller on average as compared to males, but in later adolescence and adulthood, males exceed the females in the height. So adult males in the United States are 9% taller and 16.5% heavier than the adult females. So no proof exists that different degrees of sexual selection have resulted in the sexual size human sexual dimorphism. So the males feature larger trachea and branching bronchi as well as around 30% more lung volume per body mass than the females. So males, they have higher hearts, 10% higher production of red blood cells and higher hemoglobin, which means they can hold more oxygen. So they do have more clotting factors in circulation. These variations result in quicker wound healing and greater tolerance for the peripheral veins. So this was about the sexual dimorphism in case of the humans. Now, these are some of the examples of the sexual dimorphism, like the sexual dimorphism in the birds, like the pinnipeds, the fishes. So there are few examples of this sexual dimorphism. So the next slide will be discussing about the sexual dimorphism in case of the birds. So in birds, sexual dimorphism may take the form of size or plumage variations between the sexes. So males are usually larger than the females in most taxa, but that may not be the case always, such as in hummingbirds, birds of prey, and certain dimorphic species or flightless birds. So males are usually more ornamented or brightly colored than the females, whereas plumage dimorphism is the type of ornamentation or coloration varies. So these disparities have indeed been due to the sexes, which is unequal reproductive contributions. So as they have a higher chance of producing offsprings, their distinction results in a stronger female preference. So in sexually dimorphic birds, the male's role in reproduction ends with copulation, whereas in others, the male takes on the role of the primary caregiver. So their polymorphism in plumage probably evolved to illustrate these variations, as well as other body conditions and survival. So females select the fittest accessible male after receiving signals from the male phenotype. So sexual dimorphism are often influenced by migration, trends and altitude. So this factor can also be traced back to species size dimorphism, and it has been proven that greater males are good at dealing with the challenges of migration, and as a result are much more effective at reproducing once they arrive at their breeding destination. So this was about the sexual dimorphic birds. So next, about the pinnipeds. So due to various environmental factors and sexual selection, such as the breeding place, marine mammals, they have some of the largest sexual size difference among the mammals. So pinnipeds' mating system range from polygamy to serial monogamy. Pinnipeds are noted for their early differential growth and maternal investments, as the only source of nutrition for newborn pups is the mother's milk. So males see lion pups, for instance, they're slightly larger than females when they're born. So in elephant seals, what is happening? Sexual dimorphism is linked to males' ability to protect the territories and dominate large number of females, that is linked to polygenic activity. So the broad sexual size disparity is due to in part of the sexual selection. It is however related to the fact that females enter reproductive age far sooner than the males. So furthermore, males cannot provide parental care for their children and instead focus their energy on development. The secondary growth spurts in males throughout adolescence supports this. Now, the sexual dimorphism in fish. So ray-finned fish are long-lived and diverse group of animals with the most sexual dimorphism of every other animal. So females, they are usually larger than the males according to the fair brain. But males are also larger in species with male-male fighting or male parental treatment, ranging from dwarf males to males upwards of 12 times stronger and heavier than the females. So males, they can be significantly larger than the females in some cases. So yes, this was all about the sexual dimorphism in case of the fishes, in case of the pinnipeds, in case of the birds, and in case of the animals. So this was all about it. These are some of the references.